Hello, today I'm going to show you how to create a progress chart with round ends. For most of the time, we're using a doughnut chart to represent a percentage progress. And I'm going to make the doughnut chart more interesting by adding a round end to it. And this is how I'm going to do it. So this chart consists of two parts. The first part is a doughnut chart used showing the percentage progress. And the second part is by adding the start point and the end point to the doughnut chart. And I need to calculate the end point to make sure that when I adjust the percentage, it will also adjust the position. And this is how I'm going to do the calculation. I'm going to show in a pie chart for the progress. So 0 as the center of the circle and 1 is the radius. So the start point will be x equal to 0 and y equal to 1. And for the end point, I will need to calculate the x, y according to the percentage progress. Since the radius is equal to 1, so here x is sine theta and y is cosine theta. And theta will need to convert in radian, so it will be 20% times 2 pi. So here, for the endpoint, x is equal to sine 20% times 2 pi, and y is cosine 20% times 2 pi. So my data and formulas are ready. I'm going to show you how to plot the chart. So first, by selecting the progress percentage, I'm going to insert a doughnut chart. Here, I'm going to adjust the color of the chart as well. I'm getting blue for the progress and gray color for the remainder. And I'm going to adjust the doughnut circle. The doughnut hole size I'm reducing to 60%. And I'm adding a data label to it to show the percentage progress. Okay. And then I'm going to add another set, which is the start and the end point. Click the chart again, right click, select data. I'm going to add these point series. So I'm choosing one of the set of value first. Okay. And I go back to the chart again and then right click, change series chart data. For the point series, I'm going to change it to XY scatter. And then I'm going back to the data again. Right click, select data, go to the point series. I'm going to add the XY value here. So the X is here and the Y will be here. Okay. So I need to adjust the value of the axis as well. Since I'm plotting in a doughnut chart, so I need to increase the axis value to slightly bigger than 1. So for 60% doughnut hole size, I need to add 40% times 0.67 to the value 1 axis, so the axis value is 1.27. So I need to adjust the XY axis from negative 1.27 to 1.27 for both x and y axis. So you can see here my points are already in place in the middle position. The last part is I'm clicking the pointer. I'm going to adjust the marker size and color. So I'm going to match the color to stay the same as my doughnut chart. And the size, choosing built-in, I'm going to increase the size of the marker to match the doughnut chart. Okay, so here I have my doughnut chart with a round end. It's ready. I hope you enjoy my video. Goodbye.